Hello there, if you're viewing. We are just doing a opening test on Foundation today. This is the first time we've actually played the game, but it is amazing mechanics. As you can see, very smooth, runs beautifully on this system, Gen 7. Set up here. So villagers just sort of go at it in the background. Whether you're playing or not, I think that's one of the big advantages to this particular game is that it very low stress, low pressure for chill guys like me that just want to put in a little bit of time and enjoy some nice graphics and mess with some villagers a little bit to see what they do or don't do. In this case, you can see they're all just kind of standing around. But basically, you have to go about assigning your villagers to tasks, changing their jobs. They level up as they get better at them, which is kind of neat. They hack down the trees and build some stuff out of them for you, and eventually I think you're supposed to have a kingdom city style setup, but it's a free base in that there's no grid, so you can put anything anywhere you want, and it gives you a very high level of flexibility when it comes to designing, you know, your village and your, potentially maybe there's even a military aspect to it. I know you can build walls, maybe a castle, and eventually maybe you can go to war or get attacked. So, I mean, I don't know if it's that kind of style of game, you know, but I think it's part of the genre or intended genre eventually. So right now I have very few villagers. Most of them are standing around because I'm not really micromanaging them as much as you're supposed to here. But you can move the tabs around nicely. And there's all kinds of overlays. So you can see, you know, where your territory is that you own, where you can allow your villagers to extract, and what sort of zones you set up. And then, but generally, if you're not always assigning them to something, they're just gonna stand there. So once you got them building something, and they've built it, you have to specifically go in there and make them do something else, or they just like to rest. Market tender, that'd be cool. Well, this is my market so far. I have one bench that sells berries. The berries you get from the gathering hot, I believe. They take the berries then to the granary. And then you have a transporter. I don't know if the transporter does all the transporting yet from place to place. Or if the marketeers or whatever will, the workers will take it at least to, well, it says it basically it's in the gathering hut. Two berries. And you actually have 17 berries now in the granary. And then I think transporter then will take the berries. Oh yeah, check it out. So they take the berries from the granary to the market, and then your villagers then buy the food that they produced to make them happy, I guess. You can see sort of their happiness levels here. And this person, Pierre, I guess they get a French guy and get him some berries, and he's a happy guy. So welcome to you four viewers that are here. Hello, Gar Vidal, I think your name is. And I pronounced that wrong, I apologize. But this is an early setup for Pwnt Sound Gaming Studios, just to get testing our systems. New internet is up. We're going to have some chill games in the morning. We're going to have some skill games in the afternoon. And we're going to have some action games in the evening. And for those of you in Europe, Russia, and China that may view our channel, we're hoping to have overnight action as well, once we get our shifts assigned to who's going to play when. My name's the Big ND, and you may already know me from the YouTube, Pwnt Sound Productions, Pwnt Sound Gaming, where my role has been involved in sports cards. So far, we do box breaks of high-end sports cards, mostly hockey so far, and we give them away for free. So if you're interested in something like that, go to Pwnt Sound Gaming, Pwnt Sound Productions on Facebook, or check out Canadian Collector on Facebook as well. And you'll see what we do there. So anyways, the villas are chills. And if you click on the village center, I think eventually it's going to give you more information about what's going on in your village. The well is up and working. We've been collecting stone. And these guys need to get to work. So I think we're going to build something. You have little quests that pop up. And right now it says no quests. There's our village info, and I think we'll keep that up on the screen. Warning, all is good. We got to get them homes, I think, in order for them to start to reproduce. They call it fertility. And if you look at the overlay here, desirability for residential, they want homes down at the bottom of the map. And there's fairly high fertility everywhere on our grid right now. So, our sawmill is up and running. Let's get a villager working there. Keep our villager list up as well. I got a big screen here. You don't maybe get to see all of it, because it's actually a 42-inch extra wide. Hello, Bri. Hello, Nanny. Yeah, okay, so that being the case, because I have a huge screen, I don't know exactly what it's going to show, but maybe I can adjust the settings on OBS here. Try and widen that out a little. Does that get everybody in the screen now? Ah, says Garv. Garv, sorry, you're Garv. Okay, Garv. So we're going to get a guy who's not building anything right now to go to... oh, that's woodcutter. Is that what I need, a woodcutter, or do I need a carpenter? Okay, carpenter. He says he can't find a place to work, so let's just check and make sure. Sawmill is working. Oh, what did our villager guys do? That's not the right place, is it? That. Okay, so the kingdom recognizes my efforts in establishing my settlement. Following effect is pluses. Yeah, it probably looks a little better now. I don't know. You're way over there still. Okay, I will definitely affect that as well. If I can, aspect ratio. Which would be on the screen here. Under settings, maybe? Because the OBS shows me showing more of the screen than what I see on the Twitch. Yeah, I hear you. I'm sorry about that, and I'm glad you're checking us out here today. Again, this is a test and a preview and a playthrough on Foundation, which does look like a really cool game. It's still in early access, but they said a year, so it could be getting close to being ready to go soon. Yeah. Scale resolution. Have I gone away? Here, but I still have only the left side of the screen. No idea why. Dwarf fortress, yeah. Well, if I at least put the villagers on the left side of the screen for now. Well, I mess with this, you can see what they're doing. This is, a noob hour, of course. No, it won't be so bad once we obviously get the... ratios and such figured out. Thank you. interesting how un-user-friendly this is. Yeah, you can see what they're doing. Basically, hacking stuff apart, foraging for berries, taking them to the granary. Stuff goes to the market, and the guys buy it, and, you know, they got something to eat. They're happy. Bri, if you just wanted to throw out another tip there as to how I could fix this screen, that would be great. Maybe I should play the game in windowed mode and shrink it to fit, I guess. Well, let me try that so I don't make this any more painful than it already is. You have to see the thing move around. How stupid is that? Okay, well, I did mess with this stuff before, and I thought I had it working. I don't. It's got to be the most aggravating thing that you've ever seen. The upside down world. Easy. So we have produced some planks, I think. Maybe. Build a lord manor, assign a great hall function to a lord manor room. At the end of the month, promote a villager to serf. That's fascinating. But we don't have a house for them. That's cool. We want to build a lord manor. So I don't know if that has something to do with this. We have to figure out the parts for it. Unlock a trade route to get tools. So trade tab. Planks. We have 38, so we're going to unlock that trade route. And I'm not sure if it looks any better for you guys now or not. Looks like more of the game is fitting in. All right, well, there you go. I think that's what it's going to get for now, until the tech guys get here. It is early access too, so take a while maybe for some of this stuff to get exactly user friendly as well. Graphics though, like, check that out. That's the bird's eye view of everybody here standing around. That is, we got a high frame rate, all is good. Severity high, I don't know what that means yet. Okay, so let's see if we can do this Lord Manor thing. Assuming we need a core, we should put it on our newly cleared mountaintop. I don't know where you think the entrance would be there. Maybe there isn't one. No way in. Not bizarre. Gonna have it overlooking the mountain here somehow. And oh, we get to put a door in it. That's cool. So we'll put the door in there. And an extension. Interesting. And it can be assigned a function. put a couple of extensions on here to make it kind of look like, you know, a castle sort of thing. Put a tower there, and it really starts to look like a castle. And that's what we're going to build. So hopefully you can see it. Game looks pretty good there on the screen now, though. Yeah. Now, I gotta get some guys building, I think. So here's my Lord Manor action. And the villager overlay here is gone. Seem to always want to close it because it's kind of always in the way. But I think we're better now. They got a different aspect ratio. So, who's not busy? Got three foragers or two foragers? Two carpenters, two stone cutters. Nobody's even cutting wood right now. Let's get this guy going to building. He's only a carpenter so far, really, though. You can see their skills. Maybe they lose other skills over time? No, we got skill. Okay. You can see their levels, but for some reason it's not showing up on some of this stuff. Sizes aren't fitting in. This could be a game glitch of some sorts. Send him to build. This person's going to work, she says. Gathering wood. Okay. Interesting little game. I apologize for the hiccup there. I'm going to try and give you a bit of a play-by-play as we go along, in case you're here to sort of learn the nuances of how to play the game. See if you like the game, if you wanted to buy it or not. $33 Canadian on Steam. And I've said, obviously I've read mixed reviews here at this point in early access. A lot of people say, you know, 8, 9, 10 hours and you've done everything. Other guys I've seen have played 100 hours or more. And they seemed content to keep playing. And building. So I guess it's what you believe is your end game in this case probably would dictate how much you like this type of genre. But if you do like the idea that we're going to give you some gaming action, please follow our channel and tune in from time to time to see what we're up to. I'm looking at my market right now, thinking it's a little skimpy. I think we can add parts to it. Goods. I don't think we have goods, so I'm just going to leave it. Let's figure out what's going on with our trade. I think we need to get more tools. And we can sell here as well, obviously. So We got a bit of extra stone and a bit of extra berries. So all above the value. So maybe we set this for how many we want to keep around. And then we sell the rest. And try the same with the stone. We might need to build a warehouse to be able to do this. I'm going to check that. And then tools. Try and get ourselves to 20. I don't know if we have a sort of value on this stuff here, or where I find that at this point, but I will try and figure that out as well. Thanks, Nav. Glad to have you join. So there is all kinds of cool stuff. We get into glass, fish, honey, wine. You know your villagers want wine. There is no question about it. So I need to figure out now, do I need a trading post? Or do I need a warehouse? Says stocking and trading resources. So that's my guess. And I'm going to need 15 planks and 10 stone and 50 gold. Whoa, I got gold. Okay, we're getting gold. I'm going to try and figure out why we're getting gold here in a minute. But in the meantime, we don't have a lot of space left at this point in time in our village because of this startup. Area that they give you. I'm just going to try and squeeze it in down here. Bottom of our city center. Tree. Yeah, the music's soothing. Nice from in the morning when you're having your coffee. There is another soundtrack option that I didn't buy. I don't know if that gives you more music. Obviously, there is a soundtrack here. And we have a look at our manor, our Lord Manor here. It's starting to be built. We probably need a lot more stuff for it. Yeah, we need more planks, so we gotta make sure guys are working. I don't know if we're gonna need polished stone for it as of yet. Doesn't look like it. Well, I'm not gonna worry about getting a stone cutter's house yet, or stone mason, I guess. I'm gonna figure out the overlays. Oh, there's our resource list. Okay, so we know what we have in stock now if we keep this guy open. A little easier than looking up top. But let's look at our budget here and see what's happening with our gold. Maybe we can keep that out for a while too. You should see sort of enough of the play screen, I think, generally speaking. Get these guys cutting wood, or one of these guys cutting wood. Who we got that's a woodcutter? Have any level. This guy's a 6. He can stop cutting stone and he can go cut wood. Hopefully. It says he can't find a place to work, but sometimes it takes a couple seconds for them to figure out. Well, they're not assigned automatically. G'day.
I
Hey, sorry about that. The guy's here to put the security system in the new studio. Remember that game Black and White where you could pick up the villagers and toss them around? Well, I'm afraid not. At least I can't find an easy option for it. It doesn't mean that you completely can't. Okay, so I'm just going to physically look at these villagers and see what they're doing. It's not letting me. Oh, I'm doing something else, that's why. Left click. Base building. Am I building something? No. Okay, this is it. Yeah, okay, I'm still building the Lord Manor. Don't need to do anymore. Free time. But I guess they just rest on their own. They got a little AI thing happening. If we have a look at our Lord Manor again, we can see it's being built. It's going to give us a plus 11 splendor. I guess the splendor is part of what makes people happier. And we can see over here, villagers are buying the berries, and that's where I'm getting my income from. And I have 500. 500, so somehow I'm maxed on my gold. So maybe once I get the Lord Manor built, I can have a few more, I can hold more gold. And hopefully we'll find out more about that soon. And I'll let Philippe finish cutting those trees at the top of the hill there. And someone is cutting. No one's working here to cut those trees. So we actually kind of need somebody there. What have I got? Better go get them building. I'm trying to sell the stone. Don't know if anybody noticed whether we were selling the stone or not. Sounds great. Thank you. I'm gathering stone, they say. I got two newcomers, 8 serfs, 10 total villagers. I don't know how this would look once you have 1,000 villagers or so. fit. I'm not sure why this overlay doesn't work. Eight villagers lack space for housing. And why is it overlapping on the other? I'll just ignore the other one then. Build a warehouse and design, Lord assign great hall function. The Lord Manor room. Wow. Well, we're gonna figure that out here. It'll take a little while. If anybody knows anything that I should be doing or sees people not doing anything, please feel free to put it in the chat. Foraging seems to be going well. Maybe we should assign some more people to building. And trade. Tells me we don't have any income from trade yet. So that means we have to get our warehouse built first, and it's waiting for the builder. For the two builders that we have, then, can we assign them to a specific structure? I think they build what they want, unless you prioritize. So I guess we'll get this manor done. Ooh, or should we just put the manor on hold for now? So we get our warehouse built. I think that's the plan. Let's prioritize that warehouse. And see, they just leave the construction here, hopefully, on the manor, which we need as well. But I think without the income, the manor is not going to be terribly useful. Now, as far as the territories are concerned, I think at some point with our gold, we can buy another territory. So, as soon as I can figure that out, territory, there. So this one's got some stone on it, but it has a really another big slope, and this one takes us, oh, it's got some, we can buy this land free. So there, we bought it, I believe. We own that land. And we can expand our territory into that now, which is nice, because it looks like there might even be some berries or something over here. Actual naturally occurring berries than having to forage for them. It's almost like a little farm. And I'm going to just say that we can go ahead to cut all these trees right here if they want. Give us more space. And I'm even going to go as far as to destroy this woodcutter now. I'll assign you, Philippe. And we're going to get rid of it. Because we don't need to cut wood there anymore. It's cleared nicely for our manor. And we're going to cut this wood. Because it'll give us more space. The stuff around the town here, these little coniferous trees, I'm just leaving those for now because hopefully it'll add to our aesthetics a little bit as far as our town develops. But, you know, over time, you run out of space, you know those trees are going to come down. They all seem to be functioning fairly normally. Our gold is at full. I think we could get lucky quickly by... Oh, it went down again to 499. We need 500 to buy more property. I'd like to get that piece there with the stone on it, so they don't have to go so far to extract. There we go. I snagged it. Just before our gold went away. So we got a bigger territory now, but we're out of gold. Quirky. It's quirky stuff. Yeah, just so you know, in case you're wondering why it looks so goofy, what just happened there, is apparently trying to figure out how to move around these windows in windowed mode so that I can do other things off camera, and the game just keeps grabbing the cursor for whatever reason. So I don't know, was I away? I don't know why. Again, there's some serious quirks, and it could be this game too, partially the windowed mode. Like, I can't even move the windows without the game just deciding to move if you hit it the wrong way. So I'm trying my best here. Can't shrink the window for some reason, which is really odd. And yeah, so I don't know. That's something we're going to have to figure out how the mechanics of that work, too. Something I think just got built. Is that a warehouse? Oh, no, it's short on planks. But I do have a villager working on planks. Maybe we have to put another builder back on carpentry. Oh, that's frustrating. The windowed mode seems to have some flaws. Hopefully I'll be able to figure that out someday. Why I can't resize the window at this point. Annoying. So we lost a viewer, I guess, maybe. Maybe not. I don't know who's here and who's not. But if you are here, it's time to figure out the trade. So we're just trying to get the last couple of planks cranked out here. And these builders going on carpentry. Real delay, and when they figure out that, and they're being switched into a new job and where the job is, I don't know if that's intentional. Kind of like they're telling you, you know, yeah, you just assigned this guy a new job, but he doesn't really know where it is yet. Transporter. Keep expecting a pull out a gun. Jump in his BMW or Mercedes. It was in the briefcase. Okay, so we've got the warehouse, and it's telling me... Okay, I can pick somebody, maybe. Transporter, stonecutter, builder, stonecutter. All I have extra is stonecutters. We'll put Otto in there. And then there was also some sort of a dude came in and asked me to start working on a berry delivery. Oh, and our manor is complete. What goes on here, I wonder? We have a lord manor, so that gave us... And we can assign a great hall function to a lord manor room. Do I have a lord manor room? We have a core. I have an extension. I have a wooden tower. Why does it keep doing that? Maybe it's under this state manager? Carrying in the wood. I hear cutting it. Well, you don't have to look there anymore. Too much happening that way. Planks. Not enough wood cutting. All goods, I don't think. Put her in the lumber camp. Cut trees. Kind of cool how they build their own little roads here and stuff. Do that. Oh, this must be the guy coming on the horse. Made a path into my village too. And as far as our budget's concerned, losing money to trade. Okay, so we need to shut our trade down here. Buying way too much. Tools. Well, that shouldn't say that. Now, what do we have for tools? We have 20. So, what did we say we were going to buy to? Anybody remembers? Set up 20. So, we're done buying. I think. Buy until inventory reaches the valley. Now I see we got prices here from the other towns, neighboring cities. A lot of guys not doing anything again. Oh, they're on their free time. Unable to find a close enough to my workplace. So, and now that we have the Lord Manor, does that mean we can then build houses? Or do they build their own houses? Again, on this, need 20 surf, maybe, before I can build stuff. I don't really know. Wooden keep. Hello, Austin. Welcome to Foundation, a new city-building simulator that has no grid. It's free form. So you can place your items wherever you want. Your villagers kind of have their mind of their own. But you can assign them jobs, and if you're lucky, they'll go do them. I'm not building anything right now, so let's stop building. Second. Get some more action happening on our inputs. Food level seemed to be good. In-game sound is really loud. Well, I did not know that. No one said that yet. But I will just drop it a little. How's that? That's better. Yeah, well, you know, I try not to talk too loud over everybody here. So, we got people doing some work. Someone's telling me that I've been cutting in and out. I think we might have dropped once for some reason. I have no idea. But I'm at 60 frames per second. I have 0.1% drop frames. And we're putting up 5K. Someone keeps texting me, which is really annoying, when they know that I am busy. All right, so I don't know how we get these things going with their houses yet, because if we don't have houses, we don't get new people, I believe. And we're spending a lot of gold on tools right now. Trade expense, 13 tools bought for 260 gold. This is weekly, I see. We still don't have any trade income yet. So maybe we have to wait for the trader to come along. I didn't notice him show up, but maybe I wasn't looking. We still have to figure this out. Can be assigned a function. Extension can be assigned a function. So we want a great hall function. We will give the core the great hall function. That's interesting. And at the end of the month, I need to promote a villager to serf. Not sure how I do that. Well, that extension, it looks just like a wall to me, but then maybe if we look from the other side, it's kind of got a little, yeah, there's a sort of a space in there. So if I assign a treasury into one of my towers, and a study room into one of my extensions, that might give me more options. I guess I could maybe make a scholar. Yeah, so our expanded treasury size now is nice. Interesting. Interface is not what I would call fantastic, but I'm sure once you get it figured out. Mason Ra Lol. Your mom Lol is also Nanny Pond Lol. So we're just waiting to find out if we can. Oh, we did sell two berries in trade last week for 8 gold. $5. We got $5. You can see the wood cutting is coming along nicely. They're clearing out that patch of trees for us a little bit. Granary is not what I would call stocked, but somebody's taking some berries in there now. So we have 10 villagers. Only 8, which lack space for housing, oddly. I'm not sure if I need to assign more foraging or not. We've got some stone in stock, so maybe I can get one of these stone cutters back to foraging. This guy's a level 3 forager, so we'll put him back on foraging. I think it has an effect on how they perform. I don't know for sure. So two people passed by and nobody decided to join our village. That's kind of odd. Kind of disappointing. I don't know how I get these messages to go away. It just goes away on its own. Okay. I guess to get the villagers a house will be how we get rid of the other message. We have windowed mode. A little frustrating. I don't have my bottom interface available. You can see it on the screen, but I actually can't access it. I honestly don't know why. Okay, so we got two guys that we could promote. We don't have the gold for it. Which is really frustrating. Because we're keeping our tools up. And I'm not sure how to deliver the berries yet either. So that's... I'd promote all. It says I completed the quest, even though nobody got promoted, so that's cool. Tricked the game already. My army is growing stronger. We offer you some more challenging missions from now on. Long live the loot. Very funny. Alright, well, we're going to stream this for a few more minutes just to see if we can get anything accomplished, and then we'll have another episode tomorrow if we feel that the position we've gotten to in this run is worthy of continuing. I don't think we're killing it by any means, but we haven't died yet. Just have to figure out how to get some more gold going here, maybe. Back off on wood here probably would do it. And probably I need to get working on another building project of some sorts. The state management thing and all this has to be unlocked. And obviously we have no army because we don't have anything to build an army. I'm going to stop trading the tools so we can build up some gold, I guess. I don't know if we need more tools right now or not. I don't even see where we've bought any more. But we're breaking even, if we're lucky, on gold. How do we deliver the berries? That's the question. tunnel, we deliver berries. Have to go to full screen, I guess, here. See my other menus. Giving me anything. Can we trade planks at this point? Planks. Sell all above the value. That tells me that everything above zero we would sell. And we should keep some, I think. But I haven't seen any of this trading going on, really, effectively. You know, there is a little bit of trade income. And, I see. They'll only buy berries. This is the trick. They will buy planks, but they won't buy the other stuff we have. Got it. Okay, well, at least now we're going to sell some planks. We're going to have some income. And if these guys just get to work, we can maybe start to make some money. I don't really know exactly what we would need it for right now, actually. But we can cut back on our stone cutting. Provide a builder. Wrong guy. Two transporters? I don't need two. Okay, so the 30 berries that I do have must be at the market. That is why I can't trade it very much. Deliver them? For the quest? I need the resources in warehouses, it says. I didn't see where I could put. Berries in the warehouse. Maybe that was my mistake. Maybe I should just build another one if I can. No, I can't, because I don't have enough gold yet. But we are gaining gold, I believe. Maybe not. Very, very little. Need trade income. Have the planks to sell. Empty the stone, where would they take it? Probably wouldn't be able to take it anywhere. No transporter assigned. That could be why. I had two transporters. Goodness knows. We only got 30 days left to get our berries out. 2 days left. Need to get them into a warehouse. We don't have the warehouse space. So if I empty wood, maybe I can open that slot up. Oh, we just got 100 gold on trade income. That's going to change everything. Let's just keep that the way it is for now, and we'll build a new warehouse. And I have a builder ready. It's been standing there with nothing to do. We should go build that stuff. Have the materials. Here comes a dude now. Ooh, he just bolted right through. Nobody stayed again. Oh, here he is. Here. Well, I already got to deal with it, trying to deal with these berries. Can't just give up more berries. I can't even give these ones up. I'm keeping it for now. Thanks for the offer. Yeah. General spending now, I have to do. Territory taxes, maintenance costs. Keep them all very young. I am working. See, when you're 18 years old, just working at all seems like double work. Seems to me not doing anything, but what do I know? Or it's working, or preparing to work. It's a big build-up for a 19-year-old to actually go and do work. No doubt. I don't see where you can put berries in a warehouse. Maybe it has to be in the granary. Granary can't be consumed by the market. There's 38 berries there, and they've only sold 4. Now there's 40, see? I guess I could... I took the market tender out? No. Have to have a granary worker, I'm assuming. Stocking and trading. So, can't keep it in stock long enough because it keeps going to unemploy the granary worker for now. It'll build a stockpile. Or I could stockpile it here too. But then it probably won't trade. So we'll just stop taking it to the market for a while. Until people starve to death, I guess. Anyway, 12 noon, we're going to shut this down for today. Should be able to hopefully save the game. Pwntville, and we will try, hopefully, to resume again another time. So thanks for joining us today. Hope you learned something about this game like I did. Have five viewers. Had 79 views so far today in our 2-hour session. Make sure you follow our Twitch and our YouTube, Pwnt Sound Gaming. And if I knew how to turn off the stream, I would quit. But I don't yet. Yeah.